الحمد لله رب العالمين وصلى الله وسلم على نبينا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم أما بعد أحبتي في الله. This is a توحيد test with the green boys and we're going to see where these guys are, if they're learning after memorizing the Quran, do they know about توحيد? Because what we find is a lot of the youth, even the youth of Ahl Sunnah, they may memorize the Quran, but they don't know anything about the deen. They don't know how to pray, they don't know how to practice, and this is very dangerous. Why we have to learn about ilm, we have to learn knowledge and memorizing the Quran so we can practice it. So, how many categories of tawheed are there? Ahabati fillah. Huh? Abdurrahim Green.
Three.
Three, mashallah. Abdurrahman Green, can you give me one of the names, one of the types of tawheed? Okay, alhamdulillah. Tawheed al-Rububiyyah. Tawheed al-Rububiyyah means what? It means the lordship of Allah, that Allah is the creator and sustainer and provider of all things. That's Tawheed al-Rububiyyah. What's another category of Tawheed? Tawheed al-Uluhiyyah. It's also called Tawheed al-Ibadah. What else is it called? Tawheed al-Ibadah. Naam. Tawheed al-Ibadah means that all your worship goes to Allah. So the first Tawheed, Rububiyyah, means the lordship of Allah, because Allah is the creator and sustainer. Because of that, all of our worship goes to Allah alone. So that's where Tawheed al-Uluhiyyah comes in. So we worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala alone. And then, on top of that, what's the last category? Tawheed?
Huh?
Al-Asma'i wa Sifat, which means that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has unique and divine attributes, which are His alone. They're unique. You can see, right? You can see me right now. Allah sees everything. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has divine names and attributes, meaning that Allah is the all-seeing. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, Laysa kamithlihi shay wa huwa sami'ul basir. Allah says, there is nothing like Him, and He is the all-seeing and all-hearing. So Allah sees everything. Can you hear everything? No. Can you hear what your mother's saying in Taqwila right now? No. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala knows what she's saying, can hear what she's saying. Here's the ant in the dark of the night. Here's the termites in this tree. Here's the cougar that's deep in these woods somewhere. Here's the bear that's sleeping in his cave. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is all-seeing, all-hearing. That's the Tawheed al-Asma'i wa Sifat. That's why we say Allah is Ar-Rahman. Allah is Ar-Rahim. Allah is the most merciful. Allah is the most beneficent. And we ask Allah the Almighty, by all of His divine names and attributes, to grant us forgiveness, to grant us ikhlas with the bat, and bless us with ilm al-nafi, rizqan tayyib, wa amalan mutaqabbilan. And may Allah forgive us of our many sins and shortcomings. May Allah bless us and all of our families with jannat al-firdaus. Wa sallallahu wa sallam ala nabiyyina Muhammad wa ala alihi wa sahbihi wa sallam.